What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the problem when Photoshop is not detecting your graphics processor on your Windows PC. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. This problem is usually caused by an outdated graphics driver, because your graphics processor is turned off in your preferences, or because your graphics card is not compatible with Photoshop on your PC. First of all, open up Photoshop and navigate to Help and select GPU Compatibility. A new window will open up, where you can preview if your graphics card is turned on or off, if it's compatible or not being recognized by the application. To see if your graphics card is enabled and usable by Photoshop, navigate back to the Help menu and select System Info. On this window, you can preview all of your hardware and OS-related information, including your GPU. When running resource-intensive applications on your PC, you might want to disable hardware acceleration for Photoshop. This will prevent the application from strictly using your GPU to render images. To do so, navigate to Edit, Preferences, Performance. Here, uncheck the Use Graphics Processor option before saving your changes. You will be required to restart Photoshop for these changes to apply. When this is done, prevent other applications from running in the background before relaunching Photoshop to make sure that this issue is not software related. You might also want to update your graphics driver, especially when running into graphics errors. I suggest using the GeForce Experience application for NVIDIA GPU users and the AMD Radeon software for AMD users. In the driver section, simply click on Download. The application will automatically download and install the latest graphics driver. Lastly, reopen your Photoshop app and head back to your preferences. In the Performance section, enable the Use Graphics Processor option again before opening one of your Photoshop files. All of these steps and more information will be available in my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.